Good morning, church. It's a delight to welcome you on this first Sunday of Advent. Whatever your circumstances are, God promises to meet you here. Whether you're having still a little bit of indigestion from Thanksgiving, eating a little too much turkey, or that fourth piece of pecan pie, or maybe you're a little bit sleep deprived from trying to hit all the Black Friday specials, or perhaps you're feeling somewhat down with the COVID situation not allowing you to celebrate Thanksgiving the way you would hope to. Again, whatever situation you're in, God promises to meet you here. But his desire is that as you leave this worship time, that you would not be the same. Our theme this year is Those Who Dream. In a little bit, you'll see a theme video on that and with our theme song for this season. Some of you are wondering what the blue board is. After each of my messages through this season, I will be painting a little bit more. It's called Dreams Unfold. And so by the time we get through Christmas Eve, the picture will be completed. Now let us prepare our hearts as we come to our call to worship.
The power of dreams lies in waking up, for when we close our eyes,
we can see a better world.
When we close our eyes,
we can dream a better dream.
But when we open our eyes,
we begin the work of faith.
The power of worship is the same when we enter this space.
We can see a better world.
When we enter this space,
we dream a better dream.
When we enter this space,
we begin the work of faith.
So come in. Dream your dream.
Find hope here.
For in an hour,
we will begin the work of faith.
Let it be so. In the middle of worldwide turmoil, darkness descends. And the people cry out, "Save us, Lord." Our cries have been heard, and the word which resides with God is ready to come to us. Lord, hear our pleas and enter our hearts and lives this day. Help us to be ready for the coming of Jesus. Amen.
As I mentioned, we are going to see our theme video. We're thankful for a ministry called A Sanctified Art. Each year they do a theme, and this year it was Those Who Dream, and so the material we have has been relied very much on what they have provided, as well as some adaptations of it. I encourage you just to kind of soak in and let, you know, the Spirit just saturate you as you see some amazing artwork and hear our theme song.
There's so much sorrow here, so much shame and hurt and fear. And this grief feels like the ache is never ending. The night is long, can't find sleep. Where's peace gone? It's so hard to breathe. It's time to dream fierce dreams like Mary did. Brave dreams like Joseph did. New dreams like have the words to pray. No comfort, no joy today. Where is love we long to see? A new beginning. The night is long, can't find sleep. Where's peace gone? It's so hard to breathe. It's time to dream fierce dreams like Mary did. Brave dreams like Joseph did. New dreams like Jesus did. 'Cause those who dream change. Those who dream change everything. Seeds grow in the dark. Hope's born in the dark. Dreams start in the dark. So don't give up. Don't give up. Time to live fierce dreams like Mary did. Brave dreams like Joseph did. New dreams like Jesus did. 'Cause those who dream change everything. Those who dream change everything.
I dream of sunflower fields.
I dream of key lime pie with a mile-high meringue.
I dream of the days when we could be part of a crowd.
I dream of snow days.
I dream of empty beds and jail cells.
I dream of a world that will let kids be kids.
I dream of full tables instead of empty bellies.
I dream of schools with enough money to teach.
I dream of parents with enough money to feed.
I dream to keep awake, because if we don't dream of better days, then we might forget that this is not what God imagined.
So today, we light the candle of hope, for hope is the very thing that keeps dreams afloat.
May this light be an invitation to keep awake.
May this light be our invitation to be Advent people. People who dream. Amen.
Out of the darkness, from the shadow of death, free your people, Lord, from their fear. The rising sun appears with healing in his wings, glorious wings. Blessed be the Lord God, the God of Israel, who has come to set us free. Our God has raised the mighty Savior from the house of David. And then through the holy prophets he promised of old to save us from our captors, from the hands of all our foes. Out of darkness, from the shadow of death, us free from all our foes. Set the people free to worship, give praise without fear. We are holy and righteous forever in His sight. Appears with healing in His wings, glorious wings. You shall be called child, the prophet of the Lord, of the Lord our God Most High. Bring to the knowledge of salvation by forgiveness of their sins. In God's tender compassion, see the dawn breaking through, shining down on those in darkness, leading to the way of peace. Darkness from the shadow of death. Free your people, Lord, from their fear. The rising sun appears with healing with His wings, glorious wings. All glory to the Father, glory to the Son, to the Spirit, three as one. For as it was in the beginning and is now, evermore, evermore.
Original dreamer, over and over again in Scripture, we hear your dream for a beautiful world. We hear your dream for peace and reconciliation. We hear your dream for harmony and togetherness. We hear your dream for community and hope. We hear your dreams, and yet we do not open our eyes. We continue to live with the curtains drawn, the covers pulled tight, eyes shut to the realities of the world. Forgive us. Kindle a hope in us that will burn through the darkest nights. Give us the strength and the will to keep awake in this sleeping world. With hope we pray. Amen.
She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins.
As we prepare to look into God's word and meditate on it, please pray with me. Lord God, we are thankful that through your word you shared your dreams. And you are a God who dreams above and beyond what we can even imagine. We pray, Lord, as we find ourselves in this Advent season, and particularly on this first Sunday, that you would just guide us in your word and enable us to be able to hear your voice. We pray this in Christ's name. Amen. Our Old Testament lesson comes from Isaiah 64, verses 1 to 9. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down so that the mountains would quake at your presence. As when fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down. The mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you were angry and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean. All our righteous deeds are like a filthy rag. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay and you are the potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider, we are all your people. Our gospel lesson is taken from Mark chapter 13, verses 24 to 37. But in those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It's like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake. For you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. Chapters 11 through 15 of the Gospel of Mark could be entitled, Jesus Reveals the Temple of His Body as the True and Living Presence of God. Sort of a sub-theme identifies the disciples' inability to stand watch and pray when Jesus is at the garden wanting them to stay with him. Our text today, Mark 13, 24 to 37, inaugurates us into the Advent season on this first Sunday. Patricia DeYoung notes the following. It's a strange way to begin this time of Advent. Beginning Advent with weeping and lament? That's unusual and powerful. This is where we need to begin. The coming of Advent jolts the church out of ordinary time with the invasive news that it's time to think about fresh possibilities for deliverance and human wholeness. The Advent season ends up being played out in our culture as a time with many conflicting expectations. One is not expecting to hear a text like this when one is busy getting ready for Christmas. Black Friday specials, online shopping, plans for gathering in the midst of a pandemic, just really don't fit with the apocalyptic text that we find here in Mark and this sort of imagery. Children are concerned if Santa got their letters and if their niceness overshadows their naughtiness. People want to hear silver bells, and I'm dreaming of a white Christmas and anticipate Santa Claus is coming to town. Not the opening words of this text. But in those days, after that suffering, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light. And the stars will be falling from heaven and the powers of heaven will be shaken. What chance does our text have and what relevance does it give us in this Advent season? Well, the incredible promise within this text is what expresses the very heart of why we teach and preach. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. We find ourselves in a bit of chaos this year. Mounting COVID cases and deaths, projects yet to be finished from the derecho, a presidential election and transition that has been less than smooth, continuing work to do with the Black Lives Matters movement, yet we hear a promise that transcends the cultural focus of our time. This is where our word of the coming of the Messiah meets us. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Only the Father knows the time of the final coming of the Son of Man. Because we know that God is in charge of the timetable, we can see the emptiness of the signs of our secular culture. The call to watchfulness for the Messiah coming is the gift of this text to us, for us. The advent of the Master returning home is indeed an integral part of Advent, and we are admonished three times to keep alert, keep awake. The sign for us within the community of faith is that Jesus has come, Jesus is present, and Jesus will come again. Jesus comes not as the babe of Bethlehem, but Mark 13:35 instructs us to see within the passion narrative the fulfillment of the apocalyptic coming of the Messiah, the Son of Man. Jesus comes to us in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn. The apocalyptic sign of the cross is present in this Advent season. This is the true sign of God's salvation and deliverance from the emptiness of our time. Herein lies the connection of the coming of the Messiah born in Bethlehem and the outpouring of the Son of Man's life and death and resurrection. The events of Jesus' birth and death are inseparable. We cannot have one without the other. This is a story of God's salvation in Jesus Christ. This is the Advent message amidst the clutter and busyness of our time. Hear the closing promise of Jesus, the Son of Man, in light of all that's been said this marvelous Advent text, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Likewise, the final word of our Advent text is a word of urgency and of watchfulness. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. Luke's account of the Son of Man in chapter 12 of his gospel reminds us that the watchfulness is not merely for twiddling our thumbs and singing about the sweet by and by. He says these words, beginning at verse 35, "Be dressed for action and have your lamps lit. Be like those who are waiting for their master to return from the wedding banquet, so they may open the door for him as soon as he comes and knocks." As we have lit the candle of hope, we seek to keep awake by dreaming, by envisioning how we will live out God's promise to be with us. Emmanuel, God with us, gives us love beyond limits, gives us hope in the face of despair, peace amidst unrest, joy despite mourning. We expect God, through His Spirit, to journey with us through this uncertain time until Christ comes again. He has come, He is present, He will come again. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Amen. Let's pray. Lord, we're thankful that You, the Word, became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. Lord, as we journey through this Advent season, we pray that we can see things that we haven't seen, hear things that we need to be reminded of, and so able to dream dreams beyond our current situation. Continue, Lord, to guide us between these Sundays and enable Your presence to work in and through us. We pray in Christ's name. Amen. We'll journey this through this Advent, and this picture will gradually unfold. And we just pray God's blessing that it can be something that impacts our lives. Thank you. As you leave today, know that God goes with you. Know that God, through His Spirit, indwells within you. Go forth with the tremendous love of God the Father, through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and through the power and fellowship of His Spirit. Amen.